that we needed somewhere a little bit better to try to get our, what the heck is going on here? Greetings, adventurers. It is I, Les Grumbles, and older ball juggling red shirt over there, and I are back with another episode of our beginner friendly Let's Play. Now, last time out, we tried the purge, my first one, and it didn't go all that well. We lost 2/3 of our treasure. We lost King Kong's wee brother, our gorilla pet. We lost, I can't remember actually. Oh yeah, we lost our hyena, Chuckles. I don't think we lost any of the other followers. I'm not 100% sure. Wait for HR to get back to me with the full list. Anyway, yeah, and the worst thing is it despawned because of a bugged fighter at the end in the camp, who seemed very, very hard to fight relative to us. We lost our golem as well. Yeah, mustn't forget that, whatever his name was. And and the thing despawned before we could unlock the boxes and get our treasure. So, all in all, a great learning experience, but not the best result. So, here we are, we're back at camp. And on our little island here, I'm over cucumbered already. I decided to rebuild the little fort into a proper little fort. Everything on there is tier 2, so stone brick, with a couple of exceptions. One being, I don't know if you like what I did with the lighting, but I figured I'd go with just these wall torches for the most part, because everyone's got access to those. These are green ones. There's nothing special about them other than the color. That was basically a battle pass thing that I unlocked playing the game. So essentially, many of you probably have it, but maybe not everybody. If you came to the game after the battle pass, I'm not sure if they'll be back again, but keep an eye on, I guess, the bazaar, or maybe special events more likely, maybe some Twitch drops, maybe, I don't know. But anyway, all of this is tier 2, with the exception of the Kitan lamps that are from a DLC that I have. I've put one of my guards up there in the tower with a bow. Probably in the wrong one again. The doors are tier 1 sandstone doors to make sure that the enemy find a path, because we learned in the purge, because I'm only threat level 1, I guess. I don't know if that's correct. Help me, let me know in the comments. But I think they can't bash down a tier 2 door. So I built it in tier 2 because we're up to tier 2, so we can easily just spend a lot of time farming those resources and everything. What I did to save time for the video recording purposes is I just used creative mode just to build something that I think would be achievable. It would take a while to go and farm, but, you know, a few hours to farm all of those materials and make basic bricks, use iron reinforcements and I think shaped wood. You'd be able to put that together. The only other exception is on the towers there and on the upper level of the main fort center, you will see these pillars. Those are tier 3 DLC stable pillars, because I wanted to use door frames and put the fences within them, but that doesn't work with the configuration I've got on Conan. Basically, the game doesn't let you overlap certain pieces together, but some will. And in that DLC, there's these really neat stable pillars, so I've just used those just for aesthetics, but they won't really play a role in the fight, because there's not going to be much fighting going on around them, and therefore I figured just for the look we could use them. Here's the little fort, by the way. I've changed it up so that whilst there's still the kind of central bell tower type thing, Jeff has moved upstairs a couple of floors. I've kept that just, again, for aesthetics reasons. Just a simple fort. I didn't want to spend too much time building. So I don't know, with the creative mode, probably put that together in about half an hour to 45 minutes or something. Here's Jeff, he's up here. There's our measly treasure pile, what's left of it. And if we talk to Jeff, 318, and I think we were just under 1,000 or just around the 1,000 mark last time. But yeah, this is the central, so they have to go. They're gonna have to fight their way in here, up the stairs. We'll put some of our other followers in here at some risk. I'm gonna have to brave it and risk them for the biscuits. Yeah, and then they've got to bash down the outer doors and the inner doors. Hopefully this will work with the purge logic, but we'll find out that again together. And yeah, up here on either side, you've got a little battlements area where if we had some more archers, maybe we could pick up some archers as well and put them up specifically on the corners. That wouldn't be a bad idea, I guess, to have enough people. Yeah, so, and I just put this little fort together and put a few of those lanterns up for decoration. But you can use, you know, any of the wall sconces or any of the hanging braziers, whatever you've got, to light it up. And I went with the flames, yeah, just, you know, why not? And I like the green color. I think it kind of adds a bit of mystery, maybe a bit sinister looking, I don't know. But yeah, and then I just put some fence foundation pieces to make the bottoms of the towers, and then walls and ceiling pieces for the rest of it, and just added some pillars on the bottom there on some foundations for a bit of stability and give it more of a bit of a stronger look. But yeah, all tier 2 except those pieces that I've described to you. These are just insulated wood pillars with, again, some flame torches posted onto them. So that should work for us, I hope. What we're going to do is we've got red shirt, and he's got his full heavy gear, 559, with his armor. He's got beat sticks. We're going to go out, and along the beach, we've touched on it in one of the previous episodes, but up there a little bit, there's a really good, like a named fighter. There's like two or three of them that hang out there, and depending which one spawned in, there's some male and female fighters over there, and we're going to go with our beat sticks and see if we can persuade somebody to come and work with us that's a bit of a stronger fighter. And in advance of that, I have crafted up some more heavy armor in here, just another ordinary base game set of heavy armor, so we can get them armored up as well straight away. Hopefully they'll come with a good weapon of their own. If not, we have unlocked, wait a minute, let's change this to none. There we go. We have unlocked the Iron Warhammer and the blades, so maybe we'll give them one or the other of those. We've also got some of these as well. Oh yeah, we've got this legendary staff thing as well. Yeah, some of these look quite good. I like the one that takes off the enemy's armor. One of the other things is we did lose Kong's wee brother. Our gorilla, we have the carcass still left over, so I'm going to put that into the fluid press, and that's going to make us, well, it says bones, but I think it's going to make more than that. Let's wait a second, see what it gives us. Boom. Okay. Oh, look, 20 thick hides. That's fantastic. That's great. So that we can get those straight on the old, tannery, on the old doobly-doo. Here we go, 6 more. So that'll start us on our next. We need 30 for a thick padding to make our next piece of heavy armor. So yeah, it'll be me, red shirt, the new person, if we can get him in a moment. And last but not least, we did find that lightning head for Golem. So also we unlocked, where is it? We unlocked Iron Golems. Iron Guardian Shaper and the Iron Guardian tools. However, I had a look at the costs of them to make, and because I don't want to, like, you know, use admin mode too much and cheat you out of the whole experience that I'm going through. So just to have a look at the Iron Guardian torso, this is the base torso. It's 500 iron bars, 10 steel reinforcements, so we'll have to get into steel reinforcements to make that, 50 alchemical base, and 20 blood crystal. So wow, that's like more than we get from killing that rock nose that we know where he is. I might have to look up on the wiki where to find more of them, I don't know. And let me know in the comments if you know where some other ones are. But yeah, basically, to make the maul arm, we've got to make the iron arm. The iron arm is another 200 iron bars, 10 steel reinforcements. So alchemical base. So this is why we're not making an iron one. Let me just show you alchemical base. Oh, I forgot to fix the floor here. I've got to fix the floor. Okay. If we come over to our potion maker here, our fireball cauldron, alchemical base is a combination of one silver dust, one gold dust, and one ichor. Of which, so far, we have zero. Or maybe I've got some ichor somewhere, so I don't think so, though. So, yeah, we'd have to kill a lot of those lizards in that ravine through the desert that we went through the other day, the chameleon-looking things, to get some ichor, hopefully. And then gold and silver dust, I can either grind up my treasure, my coins, I think. You can do that, I'm not 100% sure. Or, yeah, we have to find some gold and silver nodes, and I don't know where they are. So I'd have to look it up. I've got a feeling they're not going to be handy just around the corner. So yeah, so that one is building the iron golem right now. I was very surprised how expensive that is, but I assume it's because the golem's pretty tough and lasts quite well. So I suppose it's fair. I don't know. So what we're going to do instead is we had that iron lightning head, and I put together the stone pieces from the bits and bobs that we'd gathered up before. And so we're going to create this stone golem. This one's going to have 9,200 because we definitely need more infantry, as it were. You can tell I've been playing a lot of Foxhole. So let's go ahead. I like that it's gone nighttime as well. That's good timing. Let's go ahead and raise up this stone golem. He's going to have the maul again, because again, I like that. That's a good one. It does good damage and knocks out their armor. And this guy's got the lightning head, so he looks kind of cool. Oh, he's tiny now. Not going to lie, that is a pretty good, that's a pretty good look. I like it. So let's see his behavior. We'll leave him on. We could put him on aggressive there as well. Okay, chase, and then we want him not to chase too far. Okay, so he's going to get himself murderized, I would imagine, on these settings. Yeah, let's see. I'll try aggressive. I've not really had a go at that before. So, yeah, we can't heal him again. He's got an armor of 304. He does 33 damage, and he's got 9,270 health. So, yeah. Come on, buddy. Come with me. Now, we can't take him, if we remember to the last episode, we can't take the golem with us to go and get some people to come and hang out with us, to get another thrall, basically. Because place must be walkable. Okay, why don't you stand there for me, buddy? We can't do that because he will murderize them. So, we can't give him a different weapon, basically. Encrusted weapons. So, we've got Iron Truncheon there. I've got my one here, which I've slightly strengthened with an enhancement. We'll get into that at some point. Let's go clobbing and see if we can guess. In fact, let's go across through our new fort. Don't have to swim. Fantastic. So, again, tier 1 doors. Hopefully, that will allow the purge. But before we call down the purge, because it happens pretty quickly, if it does work, it happens pretty quickly. We're going to go along this shoreline here on New River. Oh, lovely warm cup of coffee. And we're going to get ourselves, probably have to fight a crocodile, won't we? I've just noticed as well, I better repair my weapons before the fight. Think also, oh yeah, maybe we could have a look at tinkering and just see if we can enhance our weapons before we go to battle as well, make them a little bit sharper edged. Yeah, that's a good idea. Let's have a look at that. All right, first things first. I hope, now if she smashes, or he, whoever's down here, this warrior, oh there you go, they're already fighting that big fella. There you go, kill him. There we go. Okay, so it's a big fella here. I don't know how tough he's going to be. So let's see if me and Redshirt can knock him out. So he's a one star, Ulrik the Beast. Okay, just managed to dodge that, thankfully. Ow! Oh, he hits hard, though. Oh. Maybe he's going to come with a rubbish weapon by the looks of it. Okay, let's get my stamina back up. Ooh, look, he's hitting hard. Can I hit him as well? Because that would be cool if we could, like, teamwork. Oh, he's going to go. Is he going to go down? Stop hitting Red Shirt, man. There we go. I got the final hit in. look at Red Shirt. Oh, I brought him out without any food again. Oh, we'll eat this. Spice soup. Spicy fish combo. Here we go. Oh, he's got one gruel. Okay, there we go. Buff him up on that. All right, I'll eat the other one. We'll have a celebratory soup together. Okay, so now we need our capture item, our bindings. We'll get that. Let's give Red Shirt back his proper weapon before I forget that later on. So, boom, Ulrik the Beast. Let's go, Ulrik. Welcome to the Grumbles clan. Thank you for your in advance for your service. Let's go. And we'll get you dressed up in some heavy armor. Actually, we'll have a look at your armor first. But he's a big fella, isn't he? Ulrik the Beast, aptly named. So we're off to a great start here. Got ourselves another follower. So the other way of doing that, by the way, with the knockout is what I would normally do. But I'm foregoing it this time around, which might be causing me more trouble, is if you go with a shield, and then you can basically just block with the shield most of the attacks. And it depends, though, he could have a shield breaker kind of attack as well, so be careful. But you block a lot of it, and then once their animation is finished, obviously, then you just oops, I don't come in here bit too soon. You just get the timing down and beat them up. No room. We've already got the we got this crafter. I forgot about that one. Okay, let's play that forward. Wonderful. All right, hopefully he's not going to take too long. Let's have a look at who this crafter is and what they do for us, because I honestly I'm not sure. Over cucumbered. Hello. Sorry, don't mean to have the beat stick out. That's not a great way to make a first impression, Grumbles. She... What does she do? Defensive. Okay. We've got to get her some better clothes. What does the builder do? I've never had one of those before. She's working on the artisan table. Roz Krana Olderdels. So she hasn't taken over from the Zamorian Smelter 2, according to the table. Roz, here she is. She's a builder force, so she helps us with carpentry. She's giving us all of these stat buffs. 44% more durability on thing items made here. That's fantastic for bowls and whatnot. I think I've said that before. But anyway, I wonder if she's giving us like a speed buff for making stuffs, but I don't know. But recipes, she's got the split wood, and she's only got the same recipes as before. So yeah, that's interesting. So she might not be all that helpful overall, but what the heck? It's another named person that's joined us. Oh, these two thralls here both impact the table. I think you can choose which one you want. Oh, I've never seen that before. So if you want more armor pen, damage, durability, reduced weight, encumbrance 12.5, you pick this guy. And if you pick Ennis, wow, look at that. Agility weapon damage plus 2. Oh my goodness, okay, that's cool. Interesting, I've not seen that before, but here it doesn't give me the option. The bladesmith, and then here she's doing the armoring. Oh, that's really interesting. Okay. All right. Well, our thrall will get converted. Well, Ennis helps with the. That's fascinating as well. She helps with the leather crafting, I suppose. Yeah, armoring. Yeah, makes sense. Makes sense. What did you give us in the end? Just lots of bone. Okay. All right. I don't know if that thrall. We don't know in the end if he's going to actually have a very good. A good weapon. Okay, he's halfway converted. That's fantastic. All right, you've been set back to where you are. Now, one golem, one red shirt, one named fighter over there, the beast. We could. Now, what I haven't decided... Do we risk it for the biscuit? We could do. I haven't decided if I want to bring Ennis and whatnot into the... oh, she's got a rubbish... We could give them all decent weapons at least, right? Then they could do a lot more damage. Alright. We'll have to see. Oh yeah, okay. So, let's have a look. While we wait for that thrall, let's have a little look at... Oh, how am I going to fit this in? So, let's have a little look at what we unlocked. I think we unlocked the tinkering. Smithing. So, there's this really, really... huge table. So 100 wood and 25 iron bars. Well, that should be pretty easy. 25 iron bars. Okay. And then 100 wood we should have in the basic resources box. 100 wood. Oh, that didn't take because I had... Okay. All right, now I got it. All right, let's see. So this tinkerer's table is redonkulously large. So we might use our little pippy magic and shrink it down. Also, the same with the dyer's bench, but we'll see. All right, let's see if we can get this in. Well, you know what? Because we built ourselves a bit of a more spacious workshop, I guess it fits in there. It's okay. So this is the Tinkerer's Bench. And on the Tinkerer's Bench, you can do various things, such as make simple weapon repair kit and a simple armor repair kit. Now, what we learned about those kits, because we've been picking them up as drops from a lot of the folks that we've met on the road... what we've learned is that they repair, but at the cost of some durability of your weapon. So here we have the simple one. Here we have the weapon repair kit, so that's like the middle tier. And then also there's things like these advanced tool upgrades to modify your tools, make them, you know, sharper, more effective. But usually with these things, there's some kind of trade-off. So here we have a standard armor repair kit as well as the simple one. Right now, I can only make the simple ones, I've just noticed. So we wonder how close we are to leveling up. We could see if we could learn some more with the tinkering. So in here, we've got apprentice tinkerer. And then there's journeyman tinkerer for standard repair kits. There is, what's this one called? Tinker? Journeyman tinker and tinker. Okay. And these make advanced, so these just get progressively better and stronger as you go along for repairs and of your armor and your tools. Now, there's another thing that I'm interested in. I could be misunderstanding that this isn't part of the tinkering. There is also... Oh, it's a completely separate track. Okay, so you use the tinkerer's bench. You need that one unlocked, the basic one, to build the bench. And then apprentice weaponsmith... allows you to then make simple weapon damage kit. So a bag of unpleasant things have been attached to weapons to increase their damage. A simple tool upgrade kit, more efficient tools, simple blunted weapon fitting. That adds more concussive damage to things like your truncheon, so you can knock people out quicker. Simple reinforcement kit to make weapons more durable. So it doesn't add anything to damage, but you will... they'll break less often. Paring blade, or paring blade, I'm not sure how you say that. A kit that can be used to reduce the weight of a weapon. So again, if your carry weight is a bit of an issue for you, always helps, generally. You can reduce the weight of it. Now, one of the key things here, as far as I know, but again, let me know in the chat if I'm wrong, Oh, this, if you took this, it actually unlocks the Tinkerer's Mench as well. I didn't realize that. If I'd read that more carefully, I might have taken this with my points instead of the one. We only need one more point anyway. As far as I know, you can only effectively apply one of these at a time to a weapon. So I'm not sure if you replace... I think if you try to place another one over an already adjusted weapon, it'll just give you an error. Or it either does that or it replaces the one you have. So you could end up quite significantly reducing the overall stats and whatnot of your weapon. So be careful. Apprentice Armorsmith is the other one that we'd want to get. This allows you to make thin armor plating. This also unlocks the Tinkerer's Bench, armor reduction kit, and armor flexibility kit. So, armor plating increases the armor strength. Armor reduction removes surplus weight. So again, if weight is an issue for you, which we seem to be struggling because of pockets, and then simple armor flexibility, so make it more pliant and flexible. So I think that helps just with your dexterity, your movement in the armor, obviously. So that's pretty cool to know. So just be careful. Any one of those three will unlock, which I didn't realize, unlocks the Tinkerer's Bench. So you can either start working on making your weapons more damaging, which is what I want to go for, or improving your armor. And again, you go in the three different tiers. The basic, the medium, and the advanced tier, thick armor plating. I don't know what these are going to take. They're probably going to be appropriately more and more difficult to craft. That's what I anticipate. But we'll see. I'm learning as we go. I'm going to go for the weapon one because I feel like we could do more damage. And then I can take, for example, this steel mace that we've got Redshirt using, and it's got 30 damage, 24 armor pen. We should be able to buff that a little bit. Let's have a look, because we noticed in stores that we had a advanced tool upgrade kit. Let's take that, and let's have a look at what that does. So if I grab that and take, for example, my steel pick, which we made, that's the tier that we're at the moment. And then I grab the, where is it? There. I grab the advanced tool upgrade kit and I just drag it onto the tool. Cannot modify items that are damaged. Ah, okay. So we come over to our bench here, put our pick in there, repair it. Again, we don't have the knowledge for the pickaxe yet, so we can't repair it and therefore we can't upgrade it. Put that back in our pockets. Get the tool upgrade kit and drag it and drop it on there. It did something. So boom, this is now upgraded. I can't really see. I should have been more careful and looked. I don't think it changes the stats and everything on tools, but what you'll find is when you're harvesting, it's got that nice sort of purpley twitch-esque background, but when we harvest with this now, I should have checked the numbers before, but anyway, this will now give us more resource. So we're getting plus 26 and plus 28. I think before it was like 22 or 24. I'm not sure. Anyway. I'm doing really badly today, aren't I? Anybody think I was a bit sleepy? All right. So anyway, that's the process of how you go about upgrading your tools and your weapons. You're basically going to drag stuff on like that. So let's repair our daggers here. In any case, let's go out. Again, these are steel poniards, so we're into steel levels of tools. Let's go out and beat some stuff off and see if we can level. We are 139,000 away. Ooh, that's quite the ways. Never mind. But yeah, maybe we can get Redshirt. Why, you're starving all the time, buddy. You're always chomping on your food. I moved the thrall pot into the tavern for them. So let's get you a stack of these. Boop. All right. And let's go beat some stuff up. Get you, we can start with these locals again. But yeah, if we could, I'd want to make the armor upgrades as well. I think that'd be pretty cool, especially for the followers. You know? Ooh, that's loud. Crikey. Where's the third one? There's usually three. They usually come in threes. Are you up here? Or did I miss something? Maybe I missed something. Okay. So, oh, look. Another simple armor repair kit. You know, we have so many of those in the meantime, I'm not even going to get them. All right, awesome. Let's go, red shirt. Actually, I think what we're going to have to do is just level up slowly over time. Now, the other thing we could do... Oh, I wonder if our thingy's cooked. I wonder if our... I'm so scatterbrained today. Hopefully, this is still going to make a good and entertaining video for you. I'm trying. I'm a bit all over the shop at the moment. I can't get to her because she's stuck behind there. Okay. Let's see if he's cooked. He's cooked. Nice. All right, over cucumbered again. I'll get you out there. And let's look at you. You got 605. Ulrik the Beast. Yeah, we need to get you that armor. So, yeah. Let's have you on defensive as well. Not chasing too far. Combat tactic, that's fine. Okay, good. And you, unfortunately, you came with a stone club, which is rubbish. So we're going to get you, we're going to have to get you some armor. And we'll get you some, that's the drum. I want this guy. Ulrik, please follow me. Yeah, we haven't quite reached our top level. Oh, look, Ennis working on the Tinkerer's Bench now. Nice. So we don't have the, wait, where's all the good? I thought I had some gear in here for them. Ah, maybe it's not here. Okay. Let's try Perfected Steel, Battle Axe, Staff of Honorum. Yeah, it's got good armor pen. Why don't we give you this staff and see how you get on with that? And also, we pick up our armor that we made earlier. Here's one we made earlier for you. Let's see. So, we'll give you that weapon, and then boop, 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 boop. You now have 400 armor. Okay. That's alright. It's not astounding. I've got 727. Is he lower than Redshirt? I'm not sure how the armor scales over time. How has he got 559? I guess that's a leveling thing. So you're currently level 0. Yeah, right. Let's take you out then. And, we gave you that weapon, right? Yeah, let's see how he gets on with this weapon. We'll give it a little test. Let's see, I'm very curious. Curious. Curiosity killed the Conan. Or something like that. Right. And we're still nowhere near in a position to take on that crocodile. Big, big fella. I'm not even going to try it. Not even worth entertaining. Hello. Hello, local shellback inspection teams. Time for a veterinary checkup. Oops. Okay. Oops. Killed him a bit too quick there. Oof, nice. All right, nice. Should be a croc here. Yep. All right, there you go. Stabby stab. Get him. Okay, decent. 126 and 35. Oh, he's done good damage with that weapon. Fantastic. Okay, let's go. And you're leveling up as well. Nice. 687 on the health now. Okay. Let's have a look at your numbers. Increased strength. Okay, and that's a strength weapon as well. So that's great. That's going to scale nicely. Skills. All right, let's go kill these hyenas a bit. Okay. Another forewarning. We could go and kill a bunch of spiders and see if we can get some ichor. I can't remember. I think we can get ichor from spiders. So, forewarning, arachnophobes, I'm sorry, we're gonna probably... Oh, that's a handy combat gun, isn't it? Got him. Nice. Doing good damage here. I like it. Who would have thought with a legendary spear? There goes the little baby hyena. Sorry, baby hyena. Oh, hello. Boop. 127 and 36 damage. Okay, so I think the 36 is coming from buff of being with me. I'm not 100% sure. I guess that's how that works. It's neat numbers anyway. Get him. Get him. Ow. Okay. Got him. Nice. Alright, level 3. Cool. Here comes the next one. Alright, Charlie. I miss Chuckles. Get him. Oof, straight through him. 190 damage. Okay, I'm liking the look of those numbers. Perhaps we should give all our thralls legendary items. State the obvious. All right, let's go up here a bit for a change. This is where we might run into, not yet, but soon, TM. Might run into some of those spooders. All right, 116k to go to a level up. I really would like to get the armor tinkering unlocked. Not the, sorry, the weapon tinkering, and then we can show you the extra damage we can do. So a number of innocent animals might be murderized during the course of this video. Now this one is not so innocent. He's going to be aggressive. Oh, and he takes a good hit as well. Get him. Oh, okay. Yeah, nice. You're doing that annoying sort of stun lock thing or whatever as well. Let's go. Yeah, I could certainly do with upping my damage output, I feel. Let's go. Ah, look, big cobwebs. There's a spooder. Okay, final warning. Spooders ahead. Let's go. He's gonna try and spit some webbing and poison. Ow, I missed. That was silly. Oh, wow. Okay. There we go. Nice. Good kill, good kill. Right, let's see. I can't remember how... I know if I take the scythe, I think I'll get a little bit of gossamer, which we can turn into silk. Oh, look, Ichor. There you go. Pickaxe for Ichor. Nice. My steel pick. Okay, nice. Oh, bit of coal. Handy for the furnace. Yeah, I'll take a little bit. I always get so side quested, don't I? Every time I'm like, you're not here to gather. This is not what we're doing. Over cucumbered already. Okay. Here we go. Buddy, carry that for me, will you? Let's go. Alright. We'll come up here because, again, I don't know where to get gold and silver. I think, are we near the place where there's a really giant spooder to fight? We might be. Okay, let's see if we can see any, let's try gathering. I don't think you can gather here. You gotta look for the little balls. Oh, good job it's not nighttime. We're coming into spooder territory. Ooh. So, they do bleed, obviously. So... I don't know if there's any undead ones in the game. I don't think I've ever run into those. But yeah, my damage output is not particularly impressive. He doesn't. I don't think he took a single hit there. He's level 4, 700 health already. Nice. Red Shirt 3 is at level 11. So we need to do this anyway before... I heard you. Couldn't see you. We need to do this before the purge anyway, because there's no point getting a nice fighter and then not... not upgrading him. We're also getting 4k a pop here killing these spiders, so in terms of experience. Oh, missed. Ow, poisoned. Oh, wow, it actually knocked me down. That's impressive. There we go. Another level. Okay, cool. There goes the nighttime. So, pickaxe again. Or steel pick, rather. Whatever pick you're using. Sometimes gives you a little bit of chitin or chitin, however you say that. Don't really find that I'm using that, so, and it's pretty heavy. So we'll chuck that away. We've got a lot of ichor. So let's throw that in there. Here's some more. Nice. Okie dokie. There we go. Oops. I'm going to do that. Yeah, I'm not sure what we'd use that for. I guess some kind of armor or maybe some sort of process. We'll keep a little bit of it just to see. Now up here, this is what I want to show you. There are little pockets of these gossamer bundles or balls, and they will ow, he got me. He even with my combat roll, he got me. Nice. Good job. Okie dokie. So up here, if we get our sickle, I think you can just gather them off the floor with your hand like that. Yeah, plus two. And if I hit him with my steel, so there's nothing special about this, it's just a steel sickle, that's giving us plus 42 a pop. Pretty decent. Now, you see that tall finger of rock up with the two of them? Up there, I believe there's a nasty spooder, big old spooder, with a bunch of little ones around it. And I might, I could be risky with Ulrik. Kind of need to give him a different outfit so I can tell him apart from Red Shirt, but anyway. Level 5. Okay, we could try and risk it for the biscuit. I'm just going to get some more of this while we're here, because silk can let us make some other nice clothing and other materials, sometimes used in combination with other materials. So I'm just going to gather a bunch of that. And what you do with the gossamer is either in your pocket, typically the simplest way to do it just as you're traveling. There we go. Might as well just get a whole ton of it while we're here. Or at your tanner's table, I think, you can turn it into silk. So I'm going to just craft those, and you can see it goes super quick with our crafting settings. 2 for 1. So we'll get 700 odd silk. There you go. That's just going to flicker away on the side of the screen there. Let's go up here and have a look at what we're up against. We're going to attract some more spooders first. Yeah. So wait till they fire and then combat rule. We'll put your shield up. Yeah, look, I'm really not impressed with my damage output in particular. I know we've got the bleed. I mean, that's, to be fair, he's using a legendary weapon now. So, yeah. It's maybe not a fair contest. And ultimately, he's here to fight for us. This is the whole point of going down the authority track, is that he's going to be doing the heavy lifting. All right, let's get that in there. Oh, wow. Got him carrying another 500 as well. All right, maybe I shouldn't have done this. So it's not flickering on the side there. Hopefully that's not bugging anybody. All right, let's go. Again, we're not putting down bedrolls. Actually, you know what? If we fight the big boss, oh, Viper will be so proud of me. One of my moderators on Twitch. If I put down Lanavar. Oh, goodness me. Yeah, okay. So, here we go. We're doing it live. Get rid of that. We're going to take our bedroll. And we'll put that there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to go around the outer perimeter. And we're going to kill all these little ones, because as we're running around and whatnot, I'm bound at some point to attract them all in. So why don't we just go and kill them already? I'm gonna cancel that. Clear queue on the right there. There we go. Smash that button a few times. There we go. Oh, hello. Another one. Oh, here he comes. So yeah, you see what I mean? We would no doubt attract many of them as we're fighting. Kind of cool that they have this blue blood like that. You're not so scary. We know how to get rid of you. Boop. Kill it with that one over there, though. Kill it with fire. Actually, if we had fire arrows, that would be pretty neat. Look at this. We've got 26 pieces of chitin, and it's already 6.5 kilos in our pocket. 500, yeah. I mean, makes sense, but... Do you know what? I'm not going to take it. We've overdone that. Okay, let's get rid of that as well. Even the silk is adding up now. Four kilos. Okay. But what we don't want to do is go in over and cucumbered into this fight. So let's kill this next one. But if we come home with an entire stack of Ichor, that's not bad. You see that we're going to need that alchemical base for a bunch of things. Oh, it actually did a defensive thing there. It put a little, it put a bunch of, spruder webs out on the floor there. That's cool. We got stuck in it. I didn't see that one before. Okay, let's go. Let's, take this one out. There we go. So you can see those two different attack animations. One of them with the white webbing, getting ready to be spat at you, or on the floor, either way. And then the other one where it, you can see a little bit of poison coming out, and it's getting ready to bite. Oh, got me. Damn it. It's kind of distracting with that other big spider in the corner. Alright. That's a lot of them. So you can see this one doesn't have the biggest aggro radius. But I don't know, man, if we should take this one on. Your throat feels dry. Oh, goodness. Yeah, let's get it. What the heck? What's up there? Something threw some rocks down at us or something. That's weird. There's a few little places that do that in the game. It's funny. Let's see. We've got our... let's right-click on there a couple of times. Let's eat some food. Make sure we're sated. All right. Sounds good. Yeah, so what this big spooder boss... This is, I think, similar to a lot of the bigger kind of bosses you can fight in the world. This one will... Oh, there's a camp over there. Don't want to get too near that. Is it will give us, amongst other things, a key, which we can then use in... they're always fighting each other over there, silly neighbors. It will give us a key that we can use to unlock special boxes in dungeons. Which we'll see as well in another episode where we'll go and do the first, in air quotes first. They're not really sequential, but we'll do a dungeon. How much Ichor did we gather in the end? Oh, 2 stacks. That's fine. Okay, that's cool. Yeah, we'll go and have a look at the first dungeon where you hopefully get some legendary gear out of defeating the boss. Uh-oh, I've attracted in the big one. Oh, okay. So here we go. That started to... I was going to do a talk us into it. But, oh dear. Yeah. That is going to be a doozy of a fight. Oh, can I get the little one, please? Ow! Oh, no! I got myself... ow! It does a big jumpy thing! Can I get rid of the little one? At least... There we go. Oh, my goodness. He's half health already. Oh, goodness. Oh. Ulrik went down. Okay. Okay. We've got to do the rest of this fight ourselves. Get back in the fight, buddy. Okay, here we go. Get some bleed stacks on. Oh, this is... yeah, it's a bit in your face, this one, isn't it?
You picked the wrong fight!
Okay, I think we can take her down. No, don't let it get away. Yeah, do your attack thing, and I'll go around the back and backstab you. now. I don't have my distraction anymore. Ow, she got me. Have it. Now, I'm not going to risk his third. Oh. Quick, heal up, heal up. Get a heal up. Okay. All right, we're good. We're good. She's a three sculler. Yeah. Let's get some more stacks of bleed on you. That's the winner. Ow, oh, ow, ow, ow. Okay, come on. Wait for it to do its thing. There we go. Go around the side. Hit it. In the legs and the underbelly. Oh, nearly. Oh, no, she got me. Again. Let's have another healing potion. Roll out of the way. And... oh. Ooh. Ooh. Ah! Why did I do this to myself? Ow! Okay, come on, bleed for me. Bleed for me. Oh, I've done the Q thing, I've locked on. Come on, bleed out, bleed out. So close. Tick it away. Get some more bleed on. Got three stacks. Oh. Got it! Yes! All right. So let's have a look. Oh, she actually, no, she's given me a hardened steel axe, steel metal bar, lance core, and three hardened leather. Okay, and then, oh, and then we get our pickaxe and we smack it. And there we go. There we go. So she gave us a bunch of ichor, demon blood, chitin, which we don't really want. This hardened steel war axe, that's a pretty good weapon as well. Nice. And most importantly, the skeleton key. Yay, we got so many keys on us now. I should start putting these in boxes so I don't lose them when I'm out and about. All right, let's get you back in the fight, Ulrik the Beast. But he levels up again, so he's still gaining the XP and everything, even though he's down. That's cool. He's now level 7, 797 health. He did pretty well, considering he's kind of tanking, because that's that kind of weapon he's got. He's going to be standing in their face. Right, and I'm not sure. There might be a chest around here as a reward for beating that particular beastie. But I'm not entirely sure. I think I've probably had a look, or a vague recollection I might have looked for this before, and there isn't one. Let's have a look up on this rock. But no, it wouldn't be all the way out there. That would just be silly. Okay, so there's no box here. The rewards are just what you get. Let's just make sure over by here. It's kind of silly if it would be off to the side. But I think there's no box reward for this one. Some of the bosses have like a special box in their area. And once you've got another key. But yeah, that skeleton key is a very, very special one that we can use to unlock, like, the final chest, as it were, in a dungeon. You can still run the dungeon and do all the things and beat the bosses and all the rest of it. You just might not have one of those keys to unlock the chest at the end. Okay, let's go back. I don't want to risk old Ulrik here. So we're just going to head back to the camp. Leveled up. We'll actually fight a few things on the way home, probably. There's probably a few spiders that have come back. And we'll see. Did I? I did level up. Wonderful. Okay. So one more point in authority. And then knowledge. Before I forget, let us unlock Apprentice Armorsmith. Oh, and actually we have enough points to unlock Weaponsmith as well. The next tier. And the next one is available at level 51. Okay, that's awesome. Okay, if we got enough, we should have enough points to do Armorsmith too. Perfect. Perfect. Now we can do all the things that I was jibber-jabbering about. Fantastic. That was great. Well, there you go. I hope, if you're not a fan of the spiders and that, and the way it's portrayed in the game, I hope you've been able to hang in there. Or come back and use the timestamps. I will definitely timestamp around well before and well after, so that those who want to skip to the spidery content can do so. There we go. Let's go. Is there another one? Oh my goodness. Not too much of a risk here because, you know what, I'm going to try the Q. I'm going to try this lock-on system. Maybe I'm missing a trick with this lock-on. That would make me better at the combat. So it's just auto-turning the camera around. Okay, and then when it dies, it unlocks. Okay, maybe I can get used to that. That's not terrible. All right, come on, Ulrik. Let's go on. I think it might be that hyena up there on that rock. There's a really nasty, there's like a demonic hyena. I can't remember if it was on that rock or another similar one, but I climbed up a rock once and I got mauled by normal. There were two or three normal hyenas and then a demonic one, and it was like crazy. Let's go. Hello, you're gonna have some, aren't you? There we go. Yeah, so I'm very, very keen and excited to get some more, some better weaponry for my character here. And some, get some enhancements on it as well. I don't know about those drops for that weapon there. I'm guessing that's just RNG. Like, it might have dropped us a nicer, like, perfected steel or hardened steel. Poignards as well, the little daggers. But there's a whole bunch of different things in the game, and the weapons, as you've seen, the armor go all the way up to legendary. Legendary stuff has really high durability and damage and special features and things, but they, as far as I know, that they can no longer be repaired. So yeah, use them and eventually they'll break. So always have a backup weapon on you too, or be prepared to run away. Alright, let's go. Yeah. Miss and a miss. Okay, let's go. Those guys are not really doing much damage to us anymore, which is good, because this is, again, the starter area, so that's what you'd expect. And here we go. We're back to little Fort Grumbles. We'll call it Fort. That'll do. I'm not spending too much time building up. All right, eggs. Fresh eggs for breakfast. Nice. You know what? Let's harvest some meat while we're here. And some hides. I've been foregoing a lot of the harvesting. Like, typically you could stop and grab all the things you want, obviously. It's all adding up over time, helping you progress. But just in the interest of saving time for the recording, I mean, I could always skip ahead, but you know the drill. Right, let's get back here. So, there he is, still juggling his balls over there in the fort. Yeah, I want to make him some different, a different outfit so that he's, it's not so, confusing looking at the pair of them, but we'll see. Alright, still haven't fixed that floor. Nice, good work. So, we've got a bunch of that Ichor. That's excellent. We still don't know where to get, wait, hello? Where's he gone? Oh, there he is. What are you doing? What are you doing, Ulrik? Being silly, aren't you? You're being silly again, Ulrik. Okay, we can show you all the things that I talked about with the processing. Let's get this Ichor in here. No, of another way. Oh, there's one other way you can get one. I think you can build an animal pen. Large one. We've got that little one over there. Even that would do, I guess, for one. And I think you can get from when we were that place we went to over here, the den. In there, there's a marker NPC. So a lot of the NPCs here you have to fight. So very quite dangerous. But there's a few of them that you can actually interact with, and one of them, I believe, will sell you a spider hatchling or a spider egg or something, and you can put that in an animal pen, and it will make you, I believe, some Ichor over time. Again, I'm not an expert in this game. So here we go. Let's have a look. On here, we can throw those in. And thanks to our thrall, actually, Ennis, she knows the recipe to make, to weave silk. So we can throw that in there and get that work done for us. Marvelous. Let's put the silk down here on our armorer's bench, because, as I said, that's often an ingredient in various armors and stuff. I think, actually, there's probably some pieces we could make with silk now, which would look nice. I think there's a tavern, an innkeeper's specimens. There you go. Look, twine and silk. So that'll look pretty cool for our some of our folks that aren't the ones that we really want to put in fights. Yeah, I'm not sure what I've got that from. I'm guessing it might actually be the tavern, or the not the stable one, but the Darketto DLC, probably. Yeah. All right. I kind of want to get... What is this? 140? Is this heavy armor? Yeah, that's heavy armor. Okay. So I kind of want to get a different outfit, although we need something more brutish for this, for our... Yeah, but I'm trying not to cheat you guys as well. We could, show off too many of the DLCs. We could, I'll tell you what we could do. We could give him the upper body stuff, or the main outfit of what we've got on. Yeah, let's do that. There we go. Okay, in fact, we could make a new one for ourselves. Because now that we're getting it... Oh, in fact, we've got this, so we don't need to do that. Armor value 275. That's way above anything we can make. There we go. So, on the Tinkerer's Bench, now that we unlock those other skills, we can now put our bits of... Well, I don't have to put the armor in there, but I'm doing it just for the visibility. And we need to repair our steel poignards again. We did make those new, right? With the new skills that we had from Connell. I'm pretty sure we did. Yeah. So let's repair those. Okay. Then we take them over here to the Tinkerer's table. And we grab them. And we look in here. Armor. So these are, where are the weapon? So weapon damage kit. So here you've got to be a bit careful as you unlock the multiple levels. You've got weapon damage kit. Yeah, these are all of them. I just want to be sure. You've got simple weapon damage kit. So again, you've got the different tiers. So simple weapon damage kit is obviously it's not going to add as much damage. Weapon damage kit, and you can see the different ingredients. The simple one, 10 iron bars, 5 oil. So we learned already how to make oil. We learned how to make iron bars, simples. Weapon damage kit. 10 steel bars, so much more expensive, and then some more oil. So do you remember, I think at some point I've mentioned that when we squishing up the fish in here to make oil, that's going to come in handy. Well, voila, I didn't fib. So we now have the oil we need. We need some, in fact, let's put this coal and stuff away. So I've got more pocket space to work with. Boop. Demon blood, we can just put that in here for now. Boom, there we go. Oh, we had a little bit of ichor already, nice. There we go, let's get those out of the way. Put these on here. We got some hardened leather. Okay, that's something else I need to learn about. Some bush jerky, snacky snack. Okay, so back to the, oh sorry, over here. Get some of the steel bars that we've got. Again, we've learned how to make those. Let's just take 50 of those for now. I'll do it. Over here. And now we can make weapon damage kits. Craft one of those. Also the blunted fitting. Well, I already have one and you can see by the coloring there. But we could make those to apply to our truncheons to get more damage out of them. Okay, so weapon damage kit. We currently have 70% armor penetration, obviously the bleed trait, and 25 health damage. We take the weapon damage kit, drag it over our poignards. You could do it in your inventory as well. they go purple background. We click on them, and the damage is now 29. So that's quite a significant boost, raw numbers wise. That's great. Okay, we've also got this hardened steel war axe that we picked up before for beating the giant spider. Shield smash, 40 health damage, variable armor penetration. Let's make another one of these just for funsies and see what we'd get out of this. So 40. Make another weapon kit. Put that on there. So this one goes up to 44. Nice. So good old boost there. Really worth doing. Unfortunately for our new follower, Ulrik, he's got a legendary weapon. I'll just show you it for the sake of completeness. Ulrik is legendary weapons, I believe. Well, again, I can learn. Let's make one more of those. If I make, yeah. And reinforcement kit. Oh, I think that would add durability to the weapon as well. Okay, so we take that kit, we drag it over the legendary weapon. Oh, it does let you. What? Okay. Wow, okay. I didn't know. I should have looked at the number. I'm rushing today a bit, but there you go. Wow, okay. I didn't realize you could do that. Now, let's make one of these reinforcement kits. And we'll try to apply that. So we've got a durability of 1350. 1350. We take the reinforcement kit, drag it on there. And you see, look, it swaps places. There we go. That's what I was expecting. Or I'll take my poignards here. There you go. So it doesn't do anything. Because we've already applied an upgrade. And as far as I know, there's no way of removing it or whatever. Oh, that's really good. I did not expect that that was going to buff the legendary weapon. That's cool. That's an added bonus. Nice. All right, buddy. Have your weapon back. Fantastic. He's also going to obviously heal up a little bit. And not just heal up, but what do you call it? Regain some of his downed instances or whatever. So his skulls are clearing away. That's the way to describe it, I guess. So yeah, keep an eye on that. And once his skulls are all better, we could potentially think about the purge. Now, let's look at the armor. We only have... actually, let's do armor and then the search, make it a bit simpler. So we have armor reduction kit, armor simple flexibility kit, armor repair kit, and armor thin plating. Now, as you can see here, 10 fiber and 5 twine. Pretty cheap to manufacture, but again, these are the lowest tier ones, I think. Armor reduction kit. Remove superfluous weight from the armor. Increase the strength of the armor with thin armor plating. Again, let's have a look. How far away are we? It wouldn't take that long to level up to the next level of knowledge. We could go to armorsmith level. Yeah, so we only need three more points to unlock that one. Okay, you know what? I'm just thinking, because it's quite difficult to get all the gear together to make the armor, so we kind of want to make it the best we can, right? Like, if you can only add one enhancement to it, we want that to be the best enhancement possible. Alright. Well, you know what? It's a beginner guide, and we're just showing the things that we're able to do. So, let's just do flexibility. No, I want the armor plating. So, plant, fiber, and twine. Again, that's obvious that it can't be that special, right? Let's take half of that. Take one of those, throw that in there. All right, so we're gonna make a thin armor plating kit. Go. These have got stats of 121 armor value and 168. So we'll take the 168, drag that on there. You can see the little symbol. You can see that it's been buffed. And the number is now 172. So, not a ton, but not bad. And if we apply that across the board to all of the items, like so. In fact, we might as well make... we could just make all 16 of those. Why not? Boom. So this one is now 125. And yeah. Let's get you this armor here. So currently your armor value is 500. So it is scaling up as they go. And wait, did I not pick the armor up? Huh. How did I not pick the armor up? Anyway, so you're going for... Well, let's do this properly. No, I didn't somehow manage to double click those. That's weird. Ah, I'm cucumbered. Improving your armor. One slow step at a time. Oops. So, 500. Now 525. Put the torso piece on. 557. Really good. Excellent. Okay, now because they won't have taken any durability damage, because the things your thralls wear and use as weapons don't take any durability damage, which, by the way, if I haven't mentioned it before, is another good hint. If you have like a legendary weapon you're using and it's almost to the point where it's broken and it's not repairable, then just give it to one of your thralls. They can use a legendary weapon no matter how low it is and it will never break. Top tip. Okay, so again, we got the same deal here. 100 for armor value of that. Put that on. That's now 104. 140 for that. Put that on. That's now 144. Groovy. Swap that with what red shirt's wearing. What is over-cucumbering me right now? Is it? It's literally these armor pieces. That's kind of hilarious. Slow walk of shame. It's the slow walk of shame. That tavern is super popular. Super busy. Good to see. Oh, there he is. Look, he's juggling his balls so hard that he's managed to go through the wall. Good work, Richard. Right, sir. Follow me. But first of all, so his armor is, again, the standard, undamaged, 121 for the bottoms. Wait, why is this much lower? I thought those numbers looked low. He's got 168 and 121. How is that lower? And the durability is much higher on these heavy pauldrons. Oh... I know what's happened. I've been a silly sausage. So, rather than wait for the whole process of making them when I wasn't filming, I just gave myself the base items. Oh, I've been a silly sausage. So, that explains it. So, when you give yourself the base items, they're the ones that are the standard stats in the game. We have our armors... So this is a good example. Never cheat. Never cheat, kids. Stay in school. If I'd have let Ennis craft the items and just waited the 5 minutes or whatever, I could have cheated to give myself the materials, which is how I started at first. And I was like, why am I waiting for the crafting when I could just make give myself the items? If I had let Ennis craft them, they would have a significant buff. Right. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get Ennis to craft those back soon. Because I want the armor to be the best possible we can make. And why not? That's our playthrough, right? We got Ennis, so yeah. We'll be right back. Alrighty, we're back after my little mistake. I got Ennis to craft up some heavy pauldrons, chest piece and the tasset. And let's look now at the differences we were just describing. These are the ones that I've reinforced already with these thin armor platings. And the result of that was a carry capacity of 15 and armor value of 144. So that's the standard, that's the lowest the base game will give you, plus the thin armor plating, which is the lowest modification. If I now look at the heavy pauldron that Ennis made, our tier 4 thrall, we see carrying capacity is 21, an armor value of 168. Also, durability 646.9. Nice, 6.9, nice. And a weight 24.11. Down here, 29. So significantly more durable, significantly less weight, better carrying capacity, and armor value all round. Now, we take our thin plating, we apply it, and the carrying capacity stays the same. The weight, I'm not sure actually that changed. The armor value, however, went up to 172. So again, over the base game modded one, 144 to 172, definitely worth it. And here we've got 121 and carrying capacity 21. We apply this thin plating and click away and click back again. We now have 125. Perfect. So that is your basic armor modification in terms of adding some thin plating. Now, the other thing I was curious about, removing superfluous, easy for me to say, superfluous weights, if we had some more twine. Let's have a look. We do have some more twine. Oops. Let's throw that on there. I'm curious if I did armor reduction kit, because I'm actually genuinely interested in this for my armor set, because we're always having this weight issue. There's also the weapons and armor more durable, so reinforcement kit. You can make one of those just to have a look at it. And then there was, what was the other one? Oh, that might have been the only one. Let's have a look. Armor. No, there was, yeah, okay, the other one was a repair kit. That's fine, we're not going to use that. Oh, flexibility kit, that was it. So that's iron bars. Let's see, let's get some more iron bars here. Oh, there's no iron bars there. Let's see, we should have some cooking up in here. Oop, just a few, 500. Boop. Flexibility. There we go. Craft one of those. So now, again, I'm curious. I don't think we can apply multiple different things to this. So we've got this lesser one here. Let's try taking the flexibility kit, dragging it on there. Yeah, it did nothing. Okay. So yeah. Only one kind of the upgrade can go on there. All right. Good to know. So let's take our 172 and our 125 and over cucumber ourselves again. Dang nabbit. Dang nabbit. There we go. 99%. Nice. And where are you, red shirt? Here you are. Let's have a look at red shirt. So he's got 559. It's only been a little bit of an update. But now 563 and 567. Awesome. Plus, we've got these two back that we can then throw on the bench and add some more armor to. Wonderful. Now, as the thralls aren't really benefiting from weight reductions and flexibility and stuff like that, the best thing is probably just to give them more of the thin plating, like so. So I'm going to put these one. Oh, I can't do that. So we've got another 172 and a 125. Perfect. 172, 125. There we go. That solved that mystery. 172, 125. Okay, that's what I suspected. So, and this one's giving a health buff as well. That might even be an even better idea to give them this set. Because again, they don't need the carry encumbrance. They would get extra health just by wearing that armor. That would be pretty smart. All right, cool. But at least I can tell them apart now as well. So we've added additional damage to their weaponry and to our weaponry. That's fully repaired. And we've buffed their armor, which is fantastic. I'm going to put fancy things away in here. We got star metal bars, our first ones of those. That's cool. And I'm going to put all of these really cool... Actually, the commander keys. No, I'm going to put all the keys away and we'll come and get them. So that not if, but when I go down in the fight, we're not gonna worry too much. Here's our new lady. Here we go. I wanted to give you at least a different outfit. Boom. Because you're not gonna get in the fight with us, I don't think. Let's give you that worker's apron. There you go. That is a weird combo, but okay. I haven't got that much gear yet for you guys. I'm sorry. And they're complaining. Can we make some better gear for them? All right. What do I even need to make, like, the fancy stuff here? Silk. Oh, just light padding and silk. Oh, well, we've got the silk now. Why don't we make the light paddings? A bunch of twine. There you go. Let's go. Oh, that silk finish processing as well. Okay, at least we can get everybody looking kind of spry and good to go. Okay, we've got lots of those skirts. Oh, look at this blouse. Okay, that looks good. There you go. Get them looking like $1 million. Feeling better. Hardened steel for that one. Okay, that's cool. There you go. Get another one done. Awesome. Let's see what that one looks like. Cool. Oh no, she's was she still in the corner there? Was she still cutting away? She was. Okay. There you go. I think you'd probably prefer wearing this. There you go. Looking like a true carpenter. Looking like a true carpenter. Bless you, Conan. Never change. Okay. Goodness me. All right. Don't know if I need another one, actually. Oh, I'll leave that there now. Okay, that's fine. So, cool. Let's just knock up a couple of these while we're here. Okay, well, I kind of got lots of others. I don't need those. All right. Awesome. Now, are we ready to be entertaining the purge again? Ooh, okay, so I only have... We're very low. I mean, we have much better fighters. Come with me. I've got Jeff over here with the money in the tower. Look at this at night time. That looks pretty cool, doesn't it? Should have a green one up in the bell tower. But I kind of like the mixture of the colors as well, though. Don't know which side they're going to spawn. I'm going to hedge my bet. I reckon that they're going to spawn over here. Now, I guess one smart way of doing it might be... I don't know why I can't put him on that door. Oh, he goes on the inside of that door. That's kind of a bit weird, I think. Alright, I guess the smart thing to do would be to have them in that courtyard and have, like, in that way they can funnel the enemy in. And also, then, they wouldn't be able to take on... knock us out with archers, right? That could be smart. Right, you follow. And you follow. Oh, hello. What the heck? What are you doing? You biscuit. Yeah, down you go. Like a sack of sods. He snuck in. Alright. Alright, so he does count as a follower... in that regard. Right, let's get you here. Stand guard. There we go. So I think the bartender last time was when we had two guys following us because we don't have that perk yet unlocked at tier 20. I think that was coincidentally because one of them was a bartender. So the bartender follows you but doesn't count as a fighting follower, because he didn't really fight. He just had his fisticuffs out from an animation, but he didn't actually attack or anything, right? So there we go. Right, stand guard. like so. And you, no, not follow. Stand guard, but at least face up. Okay. Yeah, we, I suppose what we could do is funnel them into here. But that means they, well, no, I kind of want to fight them before they break the door down as well. Your NS. Yeah, we did give you a better weapon. If you get caught into the fight, then fair enough. Oh, we got to get you some better foot armor, though. You know what? Maybe we'll make one more, like, head and feet armor. Yeah. For Ennis, just in case she does get into the fight. I don't want her, suffering. Let's get rid of some of this junk I'm carrying around here. Too much junk in my trunk. Okay. Perfect carpenter's outfit. Perfect. Okay, so Ennis, I mean, she should look a bit fancy as well. So, but she needs the boots. And she needs, well, she could have the hat as well. We need iron bars for that. Oh, I put all the iron bars in here, didn't I? Yeah. Okay.
Heavy.
She needs the boots. She could have the fancy hat. So we'll take those items, put them in here, then we'll add, buff them as much as possible. So that means they're probably better than my ones now, aren't they? Mine is 96, 28, 128, yeah. Oh, look, so the durability way up, okay. Maybe I need to have... Maybe she can have me handy hand-me-downs. Okay. Alright, Ennis. Hope the others aren't going to get jealous of Ennis. She just does better wear for us, okay? Considering she's the one giving us all this buff to our armor. I think it's worth it. Okay, she already had the other armor. I didn't realize I'd given her those pieces. Right, let's buff those as well. There we go. Nice. And you know what? Take all of these and we might as well... Where... Because where's Connell? Are you... You're Sammy. Okay. We'll get Connell covered up as well, just in case. They shouldn't really get in the fight if we don't bring them over. Who are you? You're Connell. Here we go. Connell. Connell. I'm talking to you, son. So that one's 144. 172. Okay. 125. There we go. Give you some better armor. And then young Ennis, they're sitting down here in their undies. There we go. There we go. Okay, nice. So she's got good armor as well. Okay. We could also buff her mace, right? Oh, it would need repairing, though. Alright, well, let's, you know, while we're learning it, we might as well do it. Who are you again? You're Bricktop. You're a level zero, so... Yeah, that's my other concern, is that they're all... like at nothing level, right? So it's not a great idea for them to get into the fight. All right, we will put these away on here for, oh, not like that. Dope. Okay, we will repair this mace. Oh, we haven't unlocked mace, so we... Oh, never mind. Okay, we haven't got that one unlocked. All right, Ennis, no idea. Take this mace. Cool. Right. I think we're kind of as ready as we'll ever be. We have our new stone golem. We have our two new guards. We have my armor. You know what? I will buff my armor. This is the tinkering the tinkering episode, we will repair my armor. The bits of it that we can, that is. Obviously the legend, the higher piece we haven't got access to. Repair. Oh, it needs iron bars to repair. Okay. Always juggling all these bars around. Need to go on another iron run. Okay, so repair. 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 Wait, are these buffed ones that she's made? I don't think these are buffed ones either. I think these are just... Hang on, where's Ellis? I can't remember these things. Yeah, I apologise. I've got a bit of a short-term memory issue and I can't remember all the stuff. Ennis, there you are. So... No, okay. I don't think that's the best it could be, right? Make another one of these. 140 is the base score. Yeah, look, 168. I wasn't even wearing the best of the best myself. What a buffoon. What a buffoon. That's gonna be much better. Okay, so gloves, hat, top, tails. Actually, I made the wrong piece there, didn't I? Thinking about it. What did I miss? I missed the boots. The boots! Okay, so we get that. Put that in there. And then we tinkers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we go. That's gonna be a lot better. It was the hands piece I needed. Boop. 771. Nice. Could have been 769, would have been perfect. But anyway, 771 armor. And Silent Legion 275. Hang on. Could I? Oh, no, I can't. I think the problem is that I can't repair these. Yes, correct. Okay. So, that, therefore, we can't tinker them either because they need to be fully repaired to be tinkered. Tinker tailored. All right, now I believe I am as well prepared as I'll ever be. Let's make sure that my human thralls have got some food on them. In fact, we could probably knock up some more forage, some more gruel for them. So we've got seeds and we need plant fiber in there. Seeds and plant fiber. Let's get some plant fibers. Oop. Oh, too much. Alright, and let's see how we fare this time with some more capable fighters in our team. No offense to Chuckles and Kong's wee brother, but let's be honest at the same time. Okay, we'll just boil up some gruel. You've got to be gruel to be kind. Make sure we give them some full stacks so that they can heal up. Okay. 20, 30... 100 of those. Do with a better kook. And 100 of those. Alright, let's go. You know, that sorcerer would probably be handy in a fight as well. They're usually pretty tough. But again, we've got to balance it because the ones around the camp, the crafters, they're not leveled, right? So, we've seen the leveling is a big part of this. So you got 100. We'll give you 100. So you got 142. You can have the rest. Level 7. You're level 11. Do we take him out and level him a bit more? You know, let's go kill some crocodiles. One quick run around here. We'll kill some things. See if we can get him another level or two. So he's at least up to red shirt's level. Come on. Look at that, 149 damage now. So that's nice, those numbers have gone up. I am not ready for Big Croc yet. He's nasty. ...175 and 219 damage. You know when we'll take him on? When we can take Reg... When we get our authority, right? We need, what? Three more levels. When we get three more levels... And we can have both of our followers with us. Because we're going to go for a war party thing. Oh, there's a baby crocodile there. Get him. Okay, a little baby crocodile running off. Alright, we don't need any more pets though. I mean, we could have a baby croc in the fight, that would be funny. Probably the first to go down. But, to be honest, that leap and that stun lock kind of thing that they do, not bad. Alright, did you level at all? No, you didn't, okay. Come on then. Kill some more hyenas up here. Come on, keep up. Oh, I'm really chuffed with the tinkering. I didn't know we could... especially that legendary weapon, that got a buff as well. That's great. Here we go. I think we've got some... some doggies, I think. This. Oh, look, there's the big one. Yeah. Oh! I think. Is that the big one? No. Just another one. Okay. Come on, then. Oh, I'm stuck. Tree branch. He's really violent. He's great. Excellent. Oh, look, two poppers. Yeah, look, we're really stuck underneath those branches. That's kind of weird for Conan. It's also an unusual looking tree. Does it give anything? No, there's nothing special about it. It's just weird. Was it this cliff that I climbed up where I got into that fight? You know what? I'm curious. I'm going to go and find out. I got really beat up. It wasn't in a recording. I was just out gathering resources. Yeah, there's a bunch of hyenas over there. Hello? Red shirt? There he is. Not red shirt. Ulrik, I mean. Still mixing them up, even though I've given him different armor now. Come on, let's see if we can get him one more level. There we go. Actually, that's, no, level 8. Okay. 880 health. That's pretty solid. Pretty solid. Big buffs. All right. Ow. Nice. Easy money. I'm gonna go up here. I have no idea where it was that I got attacked by that demonic. Maybe it's not always there. Maybe it's just sometimes there. Ow. You know, I should be using this to practice the lock on, right? There's some people over there. I can't remember if we win in this cave. Oh, more rocks being thrown from above. Oof. Okay, you guys have got no chance. Archers are a menace. You shouldn't be sticking people from afar. Sinner's Refuge, we haven't been here before. Huh, and look, we can get brimstone from here. That's handy for our steel making. Oh, I know this place. Yeah, there's a whole bunch of NPCs in that. And I think there might be a cool priest or something. Yeah, let's go. We don't need to, we're not doing that right now. Because I don't have the other bludgeon. Oh no, I did probably do in my pocket. Yeah, I do. We could go down there and try and get ourselves a priest. I'm not sure. There's quite a tough little band down at the bottom. I don't think these will have anything good on them that we want, but you never know. Oh, load of exotic flesh. Why not? Right, okay, let's, you know what? Let's beat the, yeah, I've changed my mind again. Let's go in here, let's beat this lot up. And then, that will probably get, Ulrik here another level, maybe two, if we're lucky. And that in turn is going to help us during our purge. Oh, maybe we'll get lucky and get some good gear as well. Ow. Right, have it. Ow. Eh, nothing too exciting there. Let's go. Bloody archers, man. Archers are the worst. Got a one shot. Yep. Down you go. Nothing really useful there. Oh, you got someone chasing you. Ow! She kicked me! That's just rude, young lady. Just because I'm invading your home. Rude, I tell you, rude. Now, I want to, before I get to the very end fight, I'm not sure how far in. Oh, we're almost at that point already, actually. I kind of want to, I wonder if I can draw some of them out with my bow. Let's try. Or one of them out, I should say. Probably not. Oh, not shot. Oh. What I don't want to do is I don't want to draw the guy at the back. I want to see if we can capture one at the back. You're just a level one cook. And you're just a teenage dirtbag. Oh, dried berries. Nice. Don't mind if I do. Okay, so I think we're at the point where we should put the other weapons on. I'm going to give you the better beat stick because I am not very good at hitting. So this way, you'll do more concussive damage. Attack! Here they come. All right, draw two more out. Dancer two and a dancer one. Yeah. Ow.
You picked the wrong fight.
You picked the wrong fight. You see, I'm not taking much damage from these guys, even when they do catch me, so that's good. Okay, let's go. Let's keep going. There should be... There he is over there. Let's take this guy first. Hello. Oh, they're all coming. Never mind.
Oh,
confessor. Okay, you went down like a sack of suds. You're a carpenter too. You're an exile. Ow. Ow. Stop it. Stop it with the animations. Gosh, it feels like they're cheating sometimes. Okay, so Carpenter here. So you are Vatende, Confessor of Azura, a guardian. Okay, so this is what I wanted to do. Get this one. All right. And the others, I don't care too much for them. I don't think... Oh, there's still another guy in here. Okay. Come on then. Oh, you're a bloody archer. Down you go. Have a nap. I've always thought there should be something here. I've always thought there should be a crate or an unlockable or whatever. There's a whole bunch of brimstone. But anything else, not so much. Gather a little bit of brimstone. I don't want to do too much gathering during the episodes, unless it's something brand new. But this will be handy. Okay, come here, you. I want to give you back your weapon, and I want you to carry a stack of brimstone for me. Let's go. All right. So yeah, there's not a lot else that goes on in here, unfortunately. I don't think there's any lore, any books to learn. It seems like it would be one of those places. This one's always one I thought they could just, I don't know, add a cheeky bit of lore book in there, recipe book, or a couple of chests in there, get some gear. Nothing like super special, it would just be a nice little reward, you know. I don't know, maybe some gold dust and silver dust. It's a cool place. Yeah, but obviously one of those ones that's meant for you more when you're at the beginning. We need to go this way. Let's go over here and see what's... I gotta be careful now because I don't have my... I've got my dual-wielding weapon, so I don't have a single hand. I should carry another weapon that's just a single-handed... so that I can still fight. I mean, we can always put them down and just fight off whatever's coming. I think if we just run, we'll be alright. I think this person's a priest. I can't remember exactly. But this is a fixed one. It says guardian. It'd be cool if they gave us some way of making... the golem for cheaper, or a variant of it. That would be awesome. Oh, that's a big crocodile. I lost my bearings there for a moment. These crocs are back. All right, well, we'll get this one into the wheel, and then I think we'll trigger the purge. That'd be a nice little fight. Your throat feels dry. I'm sure I've got the food and water settings wrong on this, you know. It's meant to be in my favor, so that I don't have to eat and drink too often, so that doesn't get in the way of the gameplay. But, yeah. Alright. We'll get you onto the wheel. And then I shall have a short break and we'll come back refreshed and excited and ready to go. Yeah. Don't know what that symbol is. But anyway, Confessor of the Zora, Vatende. Nice. I will take a quick break and we'll be back and raring to go for the purge. Yes. Today it will be a great victory. Huzzah! I've returned! And we are now ready to do a purgerino. See how it goes, shall we? Oh my goodness. Hopefully this will work first time with the tier 1 doors. So they think they have a chance. We've got Red Shirt here. Red Shirt 3. With his partly buffed armor. All heavy, 5, 6, 7. He's got some food in his belly. And what I didn't realize is that it's a good idea to put a thrall pot down. We've got one in the tavern, full of gruel to heal him up. Actually, I better go and check the other one. During the course of the fight, I looked up the numbers, and gruel's kind of like middle of the table, better than things like grilled meat and whatnot. cooked flesh and all those kind of simple foods. Gives them 6 health a second. And gives them a plus 14 chance to buff their strength stat, which is good for our new guy. He's using a strength weapon. Vitality ones are grilled steaks, but that's only 2 health a second healing. Exquisite stew, 7. Lasting feast, 8 health a second. Plus 7% buff to their health. And exotic feast with the most. If you could feed them all exotic feasts in your pot there, that would be 10 health a second they can get back. During while they're injured and whatnot, and plus 7% vitality chance and plus 7% strength chance. So quite a good mixture. Ah, look, this is empty. I'm gonna buff that in there like that. Wonderful. All right, I've got some more oil cooking from the fish. I just noticed I've got some bugs. So we'll throw those in there, catch some more fish. And, yeah, let's get rid of this putrid meat into the composter. And let's call it a purge. And this one, I got a good feeling about this. We'll see how it goes. What else is there? Food from me, I guess. I'm doing okay. I was wondering, actually, if I could make myself a feast to give myself a buff in the fight. Feral feast, we know. That's feral flesh, cooked eggs. Oh, we don't have any feral flesh left. It's all shredded roast, okay. And dried berries. What other feasts are there? I've got the salted berries. We've got savory feast. Savory meat, eggs, and berries. Okay, so we need to go and get some eggs from over the road. Because the ones I had before expired. Alright, let's go get some eggs and eat a feast. Because I want to give myself all the buff. Well, I'm stuck on the fence. Let's give ourselves every fighting chance, shall we? Why not? Every fighting chance with our small band of warriors. Make it a bit of a Conan the Barbarian-esque where 3 or 4 people take on entire armies. Good night. Ooh, I gained a level. What? Oh my god, now we could buff our armor even. We're not going to do it. We're doing it live. Next time round, we have to make some armor. I will, give myself the medium armor buff. Fantastic. Let's get that now. Let's gain an attribute for authority. Nice. Let's gain that armorer knowledge. Boom. Weaponsmith, what level was it again? This one was level 51. We're only 43. Okay. Well, we should now be able to unlock also the pickaxe knowledge for ourselves. Oh, yeah, we need more points now, though. Awesome. Okay, we're really cracking on. That's great. We can also get the preservation box now. That's also 9 points. Ooh, goody, 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 goody. Better repair kits and things, that's okay. Not worried about that right now. Find enough weapons and things in this game. Okay, let's cook some savory feasts and then we can stop dilly-dallying around and get ourselves into a nice fight. It's a simple little fort. Hopefully it's not too boxy. I'm sure I'll get the one or the other comment. So I hate box buildings, I hate squares. All right, eggs. Oh, I fixed the floor, by the way, on the way in here. Finally fixed the floor. Okay, savory feast, cook 12, go. Bang. All right, so if we eat that, that gives us concussive damage 15%. Oh, okay, that's the one if we wanted to go Thrall hunting. I couldn't remember what the buff there was. All right, well, no worries. Either way, we got it. Feast your eyes on this, he said. Let's put half of them back in there, actually. So that in case the worst happens. When we bite the dust, not if. Oops, I didn't want to do that. Okay, let's go. Do, 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 do. Right, so let's go see Jeff and call down the purge upon ourselves. I don't know if I'm going to want to keep that thrall pot there, but anyway, I thought it looked kind of cool. Actually, you know what? I might grab it. I've made it smaller using the PP move. I might put it there instead. That way it's in no one's way. Right, Jeffrey. Proclaim our wealth once more. Prepare your defenses, scouting. Let's go. Let's go. This should be pretty good fun, I hope. If they can find a spot from their scouting mission. Drink that hot coffee. Lovely. Let's go. Bomb, 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 bomb. You've got 537 health. Okay. It's too hard to reach your coffer from outside your bed. What the heck? It's too... What? Oh, my God. What if I remove the door? Let's try that. If I remove the outer doors... Wow, what a bunch of... We'll talk about that. They don't even want the... They don't even want the treasure. Too hard to... Wow. What's Bricktop doing there? Oh, he's helping himself to food over here. That's funny. Okay, let's try this again. Proclaim wealth. Imagine if I have to rebuild this all again in tier 1. Maybe for threat level 1, the building should just be tier level 1. Don't know. I mean... It's tier 2. I guess it's kind of a tough base. Huh. This will be silly. Well, if it is, I'll drop to creative and I'll just... it's too hard to reach your coffer from outside your base. What? What? What if I take these doors away? It's too hard to get to your... Oh my god, okay. So, all right, let's change it up then. So what I'm going to do here, I'll show you because I talk about it. Go to settings, go to server settings, click make me admin. You can also do this in the console on the command line by pressing insert, the default key, and then make me admin. You can see it autofills for you there, but we've already done it. And then press escape again and click enter creative mode. And now when we take our build hammer out, we can build infinite everything. So I'm gonna switch this up. We're gonna go sandstone tier 1, and we'll just go normal walls, and we'll just I can swap these walls out. Okay, so we'll just swap these walls out and see if this is the problem. It's gonna look horrible. But I think we can get a job done here without too much hassle. Okay, and now we're done with that, so we press escape again, exit creative mode. Then we press insert and we type in make me normal. And it should say that we no longer have admin rights. Did it do? No, it didn't do it. Make me normal. There we go. Admin rights removed on the upper right. So there you go. If you've ever wondered how to do that, that's how you do it. And also, shout out to community member Silver. Thank you for the comment. I didn't know the make me normal command again. And I didn't know where to uncheck it in the settings either. So yeah, make me normal on the command line. That's how you go back to normality. The other way of doing it is just to log out back to the menu and load your world back in again. And you won't be admin anymore. All right, let's try this another time. Do you know what? For the sake of completeness, I'm going to move Jeff back upstairs. Where he was. He's in the tier 2 area again. No wonder. Well, you know what? For the sake of completeness, we'll put Jeff back up there again and we'll proclaim wealth. come on, put your camp there. Come on, I suppose realistic, I've got the stairwell there, but I could probably do a connector there to get to the outside, but kind of wanted the middle bit to be more secure. Turns out, I made it too secure. Come on, guys. Put the camp down. Is it going to work it out? Bet you as soon as I get outside. No. Oh, sugar. No. Oh, it's right here. Oh, snap. Oh, fiddlesticks. Oh, it's this side. You, big fella. Move. Come with me. Too far. Oh, come on, game. Okay. Move. Oh, no, not follow. Oh, oh no. What? Move. Here. Come on, put it there. Oh, my God. Panic stations, Mr. Mainwaring. Okay, and then you follow me. Let's go. Let's go. Big fight. Let's go. Oh, the front door would, of course, still be open. Ow! I haven't got my weapons out or nothing. Let's go, Abbas. Oh, it's a slaughter. Yes, Abbas. Oof. Barely a scratch. Let's go. Oh, Redshirt's taking an absolute kicking, but he's healing. He's healing. I'm going to force feed him a bit of gruel. Okay. Oh, here we go. Next blow. Oh, game lag there. Wow, that's unexpected. Oh, it's done it again. Oh my goodness, my game is completely frozen up. I have never experienced this before. What happens now? Okay, oh, it's back. What is going on? I can't move. Wow, I've never seen this before. I wonder if this is the game or my computer's about to die. My computer looks fine. Okay, we're good. We're good. Okay. He's healing up. He's doing okay. Look at all these dead bodies. Oh my god. Here comes the next wave. Where's all the archers? They're making a terrible mistake not bringing archers. Oh, hello. He's coming for me. Ow. Oh, it's done it again. Weird. What is this going on my computer? That's causing this. Oh wow, it's my disc that I've got the game on. There's no updates running or anything. Oh, could it be Windows update? No. Okay, so he's taking some damage, he's recovering, he's got some damage. And the golem. I can't see the golem's health right now. But it's a shame it's nighttime. I'm sorry about that, guys. I should have set it to like only daytime running. I'm trying to get in on the fight, but I'm worried that it's gonna... Ooh! Death. Oh, this is going way better. Oh my god. What's the golem's health like? Oh, really good still. 7,800. Ah, that one did a spinning cartwheel thing and fell off the bridge. Get him. Oh, archers. Oh, no, I think that's my archer upstairs. Got him. I'm going to leave that in, by the way. I could edit that out, but I'm going to just leave it in as the complete experience. Let me know in the comments if you've had similar experiences to, like, with that freezing waking up. It could also be maybe the mod, because I've got the mod that shows the amount of damage being done all the time. And maybe that is, with so many deaths and so much damage happening all the time, maybe that's too much. We've got to keep an eye out. I don't know how many waves are going to come. This has gone really well, though. He's even juggling his balls during the quiet between the waves. Wow. So I put these two on aggressive, and this guy is on defensive attacks. That's a blooming archer. Get out of this. Miserable, cheeky archer. So they have brought some archers now. Okay, so it's just RNG. Nice. Massacre. Massacre. Ow! Hello? Can we stop that now, please? Yeah, I think he's on aggressive. Oh, he's on defensive follower behavior. I'm going to put that on aggressive then. So he'll just attack anything near me. So you here, Stygian Demolisher, you're not going to get in my base. You can get wrecked, nerd. No, no. I want the treasure back that you took from me last time. The Stygian Hand of War challenges you. Yes. Oh, fatality. Oh, let's go, Ulrik. Okay, here comes another one. So, okay, before we do the challenge with the hand, let's just see if we can take these guys out. Ow. Oh, I tell you, I think adding that extra armor padding and that plating, I think that's really helped. Okay, let's kill her. Or miss. Okay, got him. Yes! Let's go! The hand has challenged you. Come here, handy fella. Here he comes. Let's get rid of the little guys first. Ow! Oh, he still hits pretty hard. You're down. Healing potion, please. Thank you. Down you go, victory. Okay. Mikey's, ow. Muppets. Okay, victory. So, why? We've got the keys. Okay. Let's see. Heal up. They've got their hands up now. Okay, let's see if the ones in here have given up now. They're not even there. See, this is what I thought would happen, is they'd run off. Oh. Okay, glorious. Let's see. Gilded Jaded Warhorn, some coins. So there's loads of treasure. Stygian Vanguard Leggings. Okay, it's only light armor, so it's more cosmetic. Bone meal. Okay, so we'll take all of that. I'm now over-cucumbered. Let's see. Iron Cleaver, Iron Tools. Stygian Infantry Rations. Durable Soup. Endure Durable Soup. Okay, some more outfits from them. That's cool. Phoenix Engraved Sword. Wow. That sounds amazing. I want to look at that, if I remember. And then, so there were three keys. I beg you, speak to me. Okay. Is that somebody in a cage? Who's this? Hello? Come on out, sir.
You can't leave me here.
You've rescued a thrall. He's a Kushite Exile 1. Okay. Go, my friend, be free. I will release you from your duties.
Please.
Be free. What about these guys? Do I still need more keys for these?
I am a dangerous man, my friend.
Please, please. Oh, no. Surely
who's that other guy talking in the corner there? Oh, he's a barkeeper as well. Okay, awesome. We'll keep him.
Listen, free me.
Beneficial arrangement. So this, look at this guy. He looks like a proper warrior or something, but I don't have any more keys left. But you know what? Back in the base, we've got keys. Oh.
They'll hear. Get me out and I will be
Can I run now? No. Oh no, I got so much stuff on me. It's crazy. Okay. I'm gonna come back, buddy. Don't disappear on me, please. Please. Don't despawn on me. We should have a bit of time. Where is... where do we put our keys? All the way over in the workshop, I remember now. Quick. Let's get rid of this treasure. Quick.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a placeable treasure. Okay. I remember that. That's a thing. Quick. To the workshop. And then we'll swim back, I guess. The more direct route. Let's take... Where are they? Three keys. Commander's keys. There we go. I think that's what we need. Let's go. Come on. Not interested in that fight right now. Have you just not seen me murder this camp right across the way here? You have no chance against me and my army. Why would you even consider? Okay, so here we go.
I am
yes!
Surely you have use of that.
Who's this guy?
I am in your debt.
Iscar the Sellsword.
Yes. I know the right rough and tumble folk.
Okay. Alright, what have you got
but
to say for yourself?
I struck out on my own. Gathered my closest siblings in slaughter under my own flag.
Oh.
We slinked away in the night. For greater glory!
For greater glory!
Haven't found it yet, but it's the journey.
Cool, okay. What have you got to trade, buddy? Oh, we can buy a battering ram, mercenary banner for archers. What does that do? Crate of explosive jar, 1,000 gold. We'd have to do a few more purges to get that much coin. Explosive arrows. Oh, that's 10,000. These numbers are a bit tiny here. Crate of exploding traps. Okay, so this would basically help you with the next time around, I guess. Huh. Oh, well, that's kind of cool. Oh, and the battering ram you can use against the, I like these banners, by the way. They look cool. The battering ram you can use against that castle that we saw last time when we went around there. All right, so this guy is, he's nothing we can do with him. Let's get this guy to follow us. Zamorian barkeeper's following. Okay, this is a good test for, come on. Ulrik! Come on. He's a one, that one. He has a bit of battle, and he can't get enough. He wants more. Could I get anything off this guy? I like that face mask. Looks cool. No, I'll tell you what I can get from that guy. I can get over-cucumbered. Yeah, well played, Grumbles. Well played. All right. Let's go. Come on, guys. Now, it does frustrate
me. I owe
you
much, but I am wasted as a fighter.
Yeah, that you can't put armor and stuff on the barkeep, but I know there's mods out there to allow that kind of thing. So, let's get these guys situated first. So that was cool. That was a purge. Took a bit of fiddling and didn't like the tier 2 ground floor. So they were like, that castle looks too hard to hit. Won't even bother. Which, to be fair, in military history... Oh, wow. I guess somebody made it in here at some point. Or there was a bit of a fracas in the bar. Anyway. Let's get you to stand there for a second. And then we grab you, barkeeper. And we kind of... Well, we have two now. So... I'll just put you here and you can keep the other guy on his toes. You two look... Are you twins?
I owe you much, but I am wasted as a fighter.
We guess we could build another bar in a corner somewhere or have another one in the building. Well, this place is going to get so ridiculously busy. But yeah, there you go. That is... Ulrik didn't even level up through that fight. Marvelous. I suppose he didn't do as much fighting. Fantastic. So we managed to beat the purge. I'm super, super happy with that. Yay. It's a good day at the Dog and Sausage. All right. Well, I hope you will have enjoyed this episode. We'll do another short and sweet this week. Do some charity work supporting Jingle Jam 2024 and the UK charity organization Autistica, looking after folks with autism and neurodivergencies and trying to help ensure that they get a fair chance at life. And yeah, looking forward to that very, very much. There's going to be some farming sim going on. But anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Don't forget to check us out live on Twitch, and if you did like the video, remember to hit the like, the thumbs up button, smash that like button, and if you haven't subscribed already, I hope I can win you over to the cause and add to our subscriber, our burgeoning subscriber army. Well, it's more of a little band right now, but we're getting there. But thank you very, very much. Again, keep leaving those comments. As well, let me know how your playthroughs are going through. Let me know little tidbits up to here. I'm not sure where we're going to take the series in terms of beginner parts, but I don't feel like we've gone very far into the game yet, so I can foresee several more episodes still in this mini-series. So, again, hope you're enjoying it. Good vibes go with you. Peace and love in your hearts. And be ready for the purge, folks. Take care. All right, I'll give you one guess who recorded some extra footage about our winnings, our takings, the treasure and everything from the purge while still muted and didn't notice. So all of the footage has no voiceover to go with it. Anyway, I put down the jade warhorn that we got. That was our big treasure, big win. The gilded jade warhorn. So if I pick that up again, and we put that onto our hotbar, press number 5, and then you'll see there is this lovely glow that appears within the radius of the coffer. So you know that it'll count if you put it within that kind of circle, sphere, or semi-sphere. We put that down there. We have a look now at Jeff, and we see that our grand total of treasure has gone up from about 300 to by 500 points for that warhorn. Wonderful. I also put the 12 silver coin that we got in here, so we have a new total. And yeah, we're almost back to the level of treasure that we had before the first purge that we fought, and it all went horribly wrong. We also got the consolation prize for poor Sammy here. He's now wearing most of a rather dubious Stygian outfit. Yeah, look, there you go. That's kind of Stygian meets Darketto, I guess. But there, yeah, there you go. So those are the cool things that we got. I'm very, very happy with that. And I thought I'd do this little addendum twice. Just so that, yeah, you got to know what we got as our spoilers of war. Wonderful. All right, good vibes go with you, folks. I'll see you in the next one. Don't forget to smash that like button.